Want to start the stream? Eesh. Yes, send it to 40 people. Sometimes you think I'm sending it to 80 people. What's up with that? Okay. While I'm queuing, I will set up my Twitch chat. Visible. Important. I should probably start queuing, huh? Because it's going to take a while. Also, that's very loud. Yeah, let's just do some instigate. Sounds like fun. Wow, when did you register that name? Julia. I mean, I don't know who you could be. You're me, I guess. Not Julia. What am I saying? I can't believe the real Frank West is in my stream now. I just opened Quadrilateral Cowboy to make sure it launched this time, in case that was like a thing that would happen. As you'll remember last time, it didn't launch. Oh, Shell's fronting someone other than me, which is good because I'm already in the chat. Oh wow, look at all these challenges I already did. Thanks. Cool to know I did all those runes. Those really good runes that I care about.
Vote now.
I won't vote, actually. I don't believe in democracy. B? Over my mask. The really important thing is to set up all your streaming equipment after you hit the stream button. Just keep adjusting shit. That's my stream advice. My other stream advice is to pick games with long queue times, long load times, and short amounts of gameplay as your warm-up. Because you want to make sure you have a lot of dead air right at the start. People love that shit. People are always like, Frank, I think your streams are a little too action-packed. Could you slow it down? I'm happy to oblige. That's why I spent an hour on one puzzle. Last time.
Эй, ты куда? Мы еще не закончили. А еще раз.
Oh, this is Team Instigate, by the way. Which means everybody has real guns. It's one hit only. But we're in team mode. And since it takes me at least two games to start aiming well, I hope you're all ready for a lot of, like, me jerking my mouse to be right next to somebody and then missing like that.
Prepare your team. Round begins. 3, 2, 1, fight.
That's a lot of people.
Miraculous.
Apparently they all jumped together as a team.
Lead taken.
Fools.
Teams are tied.
Why didn't you try? It took so long to line that shot up. Ridiculous. Oops, I jumped too high.
Impressive.
That's my ultimate ability, by the way. I see through walls. I mostly just use it in this mode to find people when I don't see anybody and I'm bored. If I want to, I can use it to, like, peek around corners and win fights immediately, but that's lame and I don't do it. What? Miss? Okay, I really hope that first one hit. The second one clearly did not. I knew it was there, I heard the jump pad, but... Oh, that could have been two kills instead of a zero. My aim is bad right now. Don't take jump pads, dummy! He turned around just in time to die. Frank, what did I just say about jump pads? For God's sake. But the answer is I don't respect them. But I demand they respect me. Oh dear. Oh, he still had spawn invulnerability. The opposite of vulnerability. Standing still, too. Cool! Love that that's how Quake works. They apparently give you more spawn invulnerability the more often you've died recently. Wait. Planned on that man moving, but he didn't, which is the ultimate dodge. But that dude just got triple railed, or he would have. I should try to shoot this man here. Oof. A lazy turtle. He's a worse version of you, turtle. I'm hoping turtle's in the chat or that joke doesn't work. I will never stop talking to myself. Unless you're telling yourself to stop talking to yourself. Which is weird. And you should stop talking to yourself. Hey, buddy. Railgun God. Impressive. Hi there.
Excellent.
Where's the men's? Oh, there they are! I found them! I found the man. I felt like that was gonna hit. I felt it in my bones, and my bones were wrong. I need more calcium. I heard that man walking. I knew he'd take the jump pad, but someone beat me to it.
Yeah.
Frank, don't take the jump pad. Oh my god. Excuse me? Feels like that goes right through. Time to read chat. Well, I quit this game very slowly and start up the other game. That was an interesting scoreboard that had infinite bots in it for just a moment there. I think that's what that graphic was. Okay, time to start the real game. Which I can actually read chat while playing. Quad. Did I read that New York article about the Babby Bone Fractures guy? I did not. I don't know what that is. What is my current Steam name, Turtle? Is it Suda is... Oh no, it's Yahweh Hands. Yeah. I just think we should all give praise to Yahweh with our hands. Okay, so if you remember, last time we completed another job and we were really working our way up in the world. And then we were attacked by a bunch of attack drones. And we went into combat trance mode. And then when it was done, all the drones was blown up, but so was our base. And of course, it was also compromised, so we had to set it on fire. Second. Sorry, I need to do something. This sucks. It will take a minute. Okay. That's done. Sorry about that. I had to message somebody at work. Asked a question. So here we are on our sick-ass airship. Which is our new base of operations. And, Maisie and Lou? I believe I've got that right. Maisie here is working on her thing, and Lou is using her bionic legs to jump up really high, and I'm sure that's... Whatever. Team tutorial, get the 3 magic keys. So now we have a tutorial. But you'll notice we have 3 things to use. And they each have different things. Kaser. And Gianni? I guess? I don't know why it's... Is that Italian? I should know. Power saw, door saw, launcher. And the greaser. Fast boots, ultra climb, and jelly bones. So let's do Kaser. Here's our little... I should have been showing the manuals this whole time, by the way, though you didn't miss much. Basically, every manual gives, like, a brief. Like, it tells you how to use your newest item, and then it tells you how to, like, it gives you a little layout of your current objective. And in this case, our newest items are these two. Press F4 to switch operatives. Oh, and then there's, like, a little... I probably should have shown this. This is neat. It's a whole manual for our shit. Like our ocular eye. It tells you how to take it out and clean it. The Weevil. Data jacks. It like goes into how the jack works. Cute. Launcher. Oh shit, there's a whole page just for like... how to reassemble it. That's adorable. That's it. Anyways. Welcome, Kaser. Roll parameters, plan, observe, and ruminate. Snap photos of the photo points. Optional, yes. Can Kaser complete the mission? No. That's for someone else to do. Can I take the photo? How do I take photo? Why am I? I see. I'm in casing mode because I am in noclip mode. Because I think the caser just flies around.
Opening door. Timer started.
Oh, that's right. In caser mode, you can use anybody else's abilities. And then you press C to snap photo. So, yeah. Casing mode is like you can go around and snap photos or shit. And just sort of like figure out what you need to do. And then we'll get to the others in a second. And you complete your objective by taking photos of the three objectives, but you can also just skip being in caser mode if you feel like it. But you don't really want to skip it if it's your first time playing the level, because you want to know what you want to do. Now the engineer is starting here. Or do I just... Oh, you just click it. Oh, that's cute. It actually goes to a point in the sky. So the engineer has a launcher. I think they might all have launchers. An engineer can open this shit. Oh, you know what? I actually need that launcher. Oh, right! That's how this feature works! We'll get to that in a second. It's not relevant just yet. The engineer can do stuff like open this. But the engineer cannot go in there. It is not possible because the engineer doesn't have jelly bones. So the engineer has to open this door for someone else.
Opening door. Timer started.
Oh, the engineer can also use the buzzsaw to get in this way. Now, the buzzsaw takes a while but opens something permanently. The door jammer only holds stuff open for 60 seconds before it closes. So now I'm gonna hit exit and go to the greaser and we'll see how this shit actually works. That's the engineer. That's Maisie. So Maisie does whatever I did when I did it. And then when I switch to Lou does whatever I do when I do it. Lou can fit through here because she's got jelly bones. Which is a weird ass noise. Lou also has very high jumps. And ultra climbing. You can jump very high and climb even higher. And that should be all three keys. Oh wait, I'm supposed to get to it. Sorry. So this little timer here is actually taking me through to where I did it. And if I mistime something, then I have to hit F3 to start over.
Job done.
And then at least one of my characters has to go to the extraction point to finish. Wow, you guys are really having a big chat in there about L game shitposting. Which, what
nine,
the? Oh.
Eight, seven,
I guess we'll watch
six,
this close.
Nine, four, three, two, one.
So yeah, it just closes. Not that interesting. And then we can view the replay over here as the caser. So the caser is just sort of in free mode. And we can watch both of them go around. And if I remember correctly, we can also play as Poncho and do, like, hacking stuff when need be. But in this particular tutorial, it's just Lou and Maisie. Anyways. Pulse Bay impound lot. So let's go in as a caser. Well, actually, wait, what are we stealing? Get the Farfic. Ah, yes. I know what this is. Have a look around. Lou's fixing up her, her leg. Her bio. Her mechanical leg. Where's Maisie? Wait, where? She gone? Very confusing. Huh. You know, I think I remember not being surprised she was gone when I first played, too. Bye. That's weird. I don't know where she is. Oh, there she is. Young Violent Love. So we need to steal lantern. We need to steal something that doesn't have a texture. Oh no, maybe it's just really dark. The heck? Huh. Okay, well, I guess now that I remember to show the manual, it doesn't exist anymore. Anyways. Yeah, the caser mode doesn't let you go through walls, so you still need to, like, prop the things open. But this doesn't really count. You're not actually propping it open. You're just sort of pretending to. So there's a data jack. This one might be complicated. What's this all about then? That seems to be an elevator.
30 seconds.
Yeah, yeah. Whew. Okay. So then this one. Ah, so you can turn this off. So you can zap down here, turn this off, and then have Lou go into the, go down there and hit that data jack.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6,
and let's see what that data jack does.
3, 2, 1.
The data jack does this. Oh, I see. The data jack opens this up and activates the tower. So when we turn on the data jack, this tower activates, and Lou can jump up here and use this data jack. Also, yeah, we're in like super outer space right now. I love how simple the effect is of just having this, of having the space elevator. Like, you can tell how simple it is. Like, he's not pretending like you can't. Like, that's just clearly a small globe that's not very far away, but I don't know, the whole thing sort of feels good? I literally can't keep up with this shit posting. Are you a Russian bot now? Anyways, what does this do? Okay, so then that opens, and here is the farfig. Someone look up what a farfig is. So then we have Maisie.
Objective complete.
Do that, and then farfig. Whoa! I got sort of trapped in it. I seem to have died in casing mode. That's fine. Wait. Okay. Optimizing these for speed is really fun because you have to, like, plan out each character really carefully.
Opening door. I must not.
So after I want to hit the button and then... I need to wait for Maisie to open the door for me. All the doors, actually. Bunk. And then I wait here for Maisie to hit that switch. And then I get out of there just in time. Oh, nice, I made it on the tower before it, And now I switch back. We rewind a little bit, or we fast forward through what I've already done. Can I get up? Okay, I can just climb out. I don't need a launcher. And Maisie has enough time to- well, more than enough time to make it out. Because Maisie cannot make it across that gap. And we watch Lou jump up there.
30 seconds.
Oh, she already hit the button and opened it.
Objective complete.
Is that the extraction point right there? Oh, in these missions we cannot move the opening, the intro and out, the insertion and extraction points. Because these missions, it's sort of like we're actually saying where we're going instead of, like, planning it out. We're actually, like, running it with each character simultaneously. And that's the planning we're doing. So, like, we can't switch the extraction points because it's like we've already decided that. And we're just figuring out how to do it. Anyways, showtime. Now that we've got our Farfig, or we're getting our Farfig in the loading screen. We have to get it ready. Engine oil change. We have a lantern, we don't. So let's see. Lou's working on some shit. Maisie's working on some shit. Lou's working on some shit. It's up to us to do the oil change. So, open hatch on the bottom. Drain the oil. I like that, you know, this... they really make you do the nitty-gritty. Let's see. Open hatch. Here we are. Brody. Return the bolt to the plug? Well, here's a new oil filter. There we go. And then fill oil on the top. Someone will deal with that later. It's fine. But the whole point of this game, like, the core idea he started with was getting across the idea of using very, like, 80s blocky technology that's, like, big and clunky but made to be functional. And I think this really ties in with that well by having you serve as just a fucking vehicle. That's it. There we go. I hope you guys are done. Oh, wait. Well, let's get this out of the way. What the hell? That was funky. I think I was standing on the oil can. I think we good? What do I do next? Oh, I screwed up the drain oil part. What bolt? Folks, what did I miss? Turn the bolt to the plug? Oh. I didn't drain that part. I'm sure it's fine that I did that after putting the new oil in. Probably. It's fine. Everything's fine. Hell yeah. Now, I didn't remember how to do most of that, but figuring it on your own, even though it doesn't take that long or it's not a particularly hard puzzle, it's just like a really neat thing, and it makes you sort of feel like you own a little bit of this boat. I didn't see what case this is. He's making air things. There's the farfig we can get on. Oh, can we? Oh, it doesn't want to let us. You can. I don't give a shit. Abuelito truck job. How come I don't have a... Oh, you know what? I think this one always crashed on me. And I've... Like, I could get to the end, but it crashed, and so I skipped it. So I don't have a time on it. I think I remember that happening. Anyways, let's acquire the safe. The vault's in the truck. Door control, door, crate. Approach angle 20. Got it. So Poncho has moved almost entirely to a planning role at this point. Whoa. Oh, I see it. So there's a chance this might crash again. I don't think so. I think they fixed that after I played it. Okay, so those are the photos, and then there's this. Okay, that's pretty simple. So I just need to get on there, and I've got a time limit before the alarm goes off. Truck jobs or blowjobs at gas station? Yes, that's what we're doing. You can open or close these railings to make stuff easier. Wait, let's restart so I don't, the important thing's first. Wait, will she put that back up now when she goes it? I don't think so. Oh, wow, I almost didn't make that. Because I jumped before we set it. The unpickable lock. There we go. Oh, wait. I need Maisie, after all. Because only Maisie has the launcher.
30 seconds remaining.
I've still got two left or two total. I'm not sure which. Yeah, bad part about this section is that you can't really reliably play music because you're switching between characters.
Go, 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 go.
Okay, they're nice to you there. And it didn't crash. I don't know what made this crash before. I remember I couldn't beat this one. But the nice thing about this game is that it just lets you skip levels. So, like, it was okay. I think in part because he knew when he was... One of the reasons he probably is because he launched it and he, like, knew that he didn't have that much QA and it was a little rough. And I'm pretty sure, like, the day after I beat it, he released a patch that fixed it. Anyway. So this, like, we just stole from a car. I love that shit. Shopping. This seems good. Fiber legs. Insert leg into hole. Enjoy the new you. Other leg. Wait. Third leg? Okay. Button. We are beyond rivalry. We are Ikanudak. All sales final, no refunds. A sweet paralyzing agent, preluded or prolonged, I'm bored already. There's a lot of oil. So there are cyber arms. Huh. Well, I trust Dr. Vape. Dr. Vapor? Okay. Jelly bones installed.
Thank you, goodbye. Thank you, goodbye.
So now we're even more robotic than we were. And I think we already had some cheap ass. I think it's implied that Pancho starts the game with some cheap ass cyber legs, but I'm not totally sure that that's true. It might just be your tool belt. We don't need to go out that way. So yeah, Pancho now has the same abilities Lou does. Got the big jump and the squeezy body. Dr. Vapor is my new UA character. Nice. Yeah, you'd think you'd do the torso first, right? I wanna go out there. Good. Go hang out. Still. While I reach out. Time to do sit-ups in solidarity with Block Lady. She has a name. It's Lou. What'd you do with Shell? Ooh, this one. I remember this one. Here's the Malta Stock Exchange. Download the trunk line. Vanity check execution. Get paid. I think I'm actually gonna beat this early, folks. If I beat it real early, I might just start No More Heroes 2. and do 3 games in 1 night and just do like the first mission of that. No promises, it depends. But I'm beating these last levels faster than I remembered, because originally they were very finicky. But to be fair, originally I was trying to get my time down really low, which is like a really fun thing to do, but I'm not doing it because I don't think it's fun to watch. I literally just promised. I don't think I did promise. I don't think I said the word promise anywhere. I don't think I've ever said the word promise. Anyways, let's have a look at what we have to do. We need to download the trunk line. Hey, what's a trunk line? Is that a word he made up or is that a thing? Anyways, it looks like we are jacking into a stock exchange that is in a dirigible. Which is cool as shit, actually. Like the coolest shit possible. This is a fucking heist. Trunk line is an elephant's nose. I don't think that's correct. I've never said promise. I'm not saying it now, and I'm not saying it later. Okay, so we start there, and we're gonna obviously have to launch her over to here. And then what? We can go over here for no reason. No reason at all to go over here, actually. Is a reason to go up there, though. But I don't think we can just launch her up there. I think that's too far. Anyways, we drop down here. We open this door.
Timer started. 3 minutes remaining.
Oh shit, we're on a timer. Better turn off the lights, so actually I need those lights to see. Okay, this is... Fuck yes. Just a... Oh god, I'm stuck in the computers. But just like a brain monitoring the... Nice. And then another robot. Why does it have arms if it doesn't... Let's turn the music on. God, that's so fucking cool. I love this. Just everything about this is my favorite. Fenordia. You can hear them all click to 12. Or was that just a minute? That was just a minute still. West Egg, that's where I'm from. I'm from West Egg, actually. That's one of my favorite rooms in video games, I think. Unambiguously. Just like everything that it sets up in there. Oh yeah, shit. That's Let's Shake, isn't it? Man. Too bad Let's Shake is dead and we'll never get to fight him. Just kidding, here he is. He's the boss. After you steal, you have to fight him in this game. Oh, cute. It's just like a go or stop thing. Does anybody have anything interesting in their desk? No, probably not. I'm just gonna skip that. Ooh, windows though. That could potentially be useful. Not sure how. We need a key for the elevator.
60 seconds.
Oh, this is locked, huh? Okay, let's see. Ow! Oh, I thought I hit the fans or something. Oh, they're not fans. Uh-oh, they shoved me over. That's cute. Probably only because I'm in noclip. Okay. Oh, elevator shaft. We can probably jump up this. Maybe we can't? Here, let's look at what's down there first, though.
30 seconds.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, I see. The elevator's in the way. Where's the key? Oh, I think I know what I need to do. So we have Lou or Poncho jump up here. Because I'm pretty sure Maisie still doesn't have cyber legs. I love that, like, so it's a robot driving the Zeppelin, but it's still, like, a man-shaped robot that uses levers. I like that a lot. Here's the override. which brings the elevator up, which does a couple things, I think. Well, it actually doesn't really help us because we can't get in the elevator, but it unblocks the down here. This robot is a coward and a bitch. Wow, Jesus, Nufkins. I like the robot. I'm with Shell. West Egg is where the Great Gatsby hatched from. Correct. Anyways, yeah, that's a good robot. All the robots are good in this game, I think. Although, don't take that for granted, because maybe one of them's shitty. Here's electrified shit. Oh, I see. This is mostly for us to take a picture through, I think. There's the trunk line. But then we... Wait. How did any of that help? What? How did any of that help? This just drops us into the same room. What did I do wrong? Hold on. I've missed something. Oh, I know. It's because I ran out of time. Hold on. Let's restart the casing. Weird that we have walking sway? I don't think we're supposed to have that in this mode, but I guess I do now. Okay, so we've got 3 minutes. How do I get up there again? I've forgotten already. Oh, yes. Stand on top of the elevator doesn't... I don't need to do that, because I can jump up the elevator shaft. No, I think I just ran out of time and something electrified or closed that otherwise wouldn't have. Oof. Oh no, I killed myself. I'm actually dead right now. It doesn't look that way, but I am. Oh, hold on. Give us some music, since I fucked that up. So it's come to this. So yeah, we can't get past either. Okay. Give the elevator some space this time? We can't get in the elevator without the key, which I don't think exists for us. Okay, so what does that do? Oh, hold on. We have items again. I mean, okay. Oh, we just download it by, like, literally connecting it, the phone to it. That's cute. Okay, so there's the objective complete. However... Oh, wait, the case has a little something. Chill! Oh, that's just... Oh, it's letting me know about using previous commands now. So wait... But then it's trying to shoot me the whole time. And that's what the override is for. Never mind. That's not what the override is for. I might have to figure out some of this on the go. What the fuck? Oh! Hey. We haven't actually used one of those yet, but you can reset the alarms, apparently. But... Oh, but then we need to do that all very quick. I'm still not sure. Oh, and then this is closed after that 3-minute timer. Okay, I'm gonna give it a shot. I'm not sure I'm gonna do it right. I will give it a shot. Every cable in the entire network is bundled together. That makes sense. I'm 100% confident I'm gonna fuck this up. Are we not doing this with the team? Oh, this time it's just me. Apparently. Well, I guess Maisie and Lou are fucking busy. I thought I'd be doing this with a team. Oof. Well, that's technically fine. I don't die doing that, so that's something. I can't just, like, jump out there right now. That'd be very silly. I wonder if I could shoot from there. Oh, well. Okay.
3 minutes remaining.
I'll just set that up for later. Get this stupid elevator out of the way. Nothing up here, right? No. Bunka! Oops, I didn't want to fall that far. Oh! No? Okay, let's quickly try this.
Minutes remaining.
Oh, but I need to connect my deck to it. And that's a button. Oh, shit! I just figured out how to do this better. But it's too late to do it that way now. So let's just do this. And boy, pitch 20. This is gonna kill me instantly. Hold on. Go. Wait. That's anticlimactic. Shit. Drop. Oh, okay.
Objective complete.
Oof, okay. Go, 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 go. I think I'm okay. Ignore the fact that I left Weaver behind. He's a sacrifice. Oh, I made it. Ooh, it worked. I'm a fucking monster. I'm sorry, Weaver. Time penalty plus 10 minutes because I set enough alarm. There's a way to do that without setting off an alarm, I'm sure of it. Do I want to try for it? How would I do that? How would I do that without setting off an alarm? Oh shit. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do it so I don't leave Weaver. It's important. And this will be, oops. I just figured out the true solution. Also, we'll be optimizing this for time a little bit. You get to see a little bit what that looks like, although not really too much. I hope that doesn't kill me when I come out.
Opening door. Time has started. 3 minutes remaining.
Okay, I know how to do this. I think this'll work. Oops, I didn't quite get that. There we go. Oh, I see. Oh, that'll kill me if I go down there, probably. Nice video feed, dork. Ooh, that's not great.
Two minutes remaining.
I know, shut up. No! It's a 3 second button! Fuck! Fuck, fire W?
30 seconds.
Objective complete.
Go, 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 go. Better make sure they don't know we were here.
10, 9, 8, 7.
Perfect.
Six.
Justice plan.
3, 2, 1.
No, don't fall off.
There
you go. Oh yeah, if I was really smart, I would have set that up on a plank, huh? Now I'll read your chat to see if you told me how to do it. Oh man, you're all really mad at me for leaving. Do I know what is wrong with chat tonight? I have no clue what's going on with this chat. I think both of you being together has made the ship post happen. Okay. I did leave Aimbot behind, but yeah, I could have just used Blink if I was smart. And the thing about Blink is you can set it. The thing about Blink is I could set it up. I could go in, set up a Blink, and then hit restart and the Blink saves. So, like, it would just happen. If I was, like, if I was really optimizing this, I would figure out where to place the gun that I know the pitch amount and turn amount I'd need, or just the pitch amount, I guess. And then I would just place it there, and then I would, like, blink to do a deploy. In fact, I could do that if you want, but I won't. But oh, I can't do it here. The command would be something like... I'll just write it out. It would be like, blink, one, exit, and then, no, aimbot, deploy, wait, two, or 1.5, I think is how long it takes to deploy, pitch, minus 10, or something, minus 20, whatever it is, probably be like 18 or 17, and then wait, two, so that the pitch actually happens, because you have to wait for the actual change, and then fire, and then that would open the door, and I'd just have this. But I won't do that. I already did a pretty good run of this. The command would just be like, see, 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 see. Anyways, we did it well enough. We didn't leave a man behind. Or a woman. I don't know. What do we call Nell, the weaver? Oh, it's coffee. Nice. That is a satellite? I think this might be the big one. Abby Yo-Yo Space Elevator. I can't read that shit. These are so relaxing, frankly. What a nice skybox. Good birds. I don't know if we're supposed to be able to go up here. What if I jumped off this shit? Not much. Something happens if you jump off anywhere. He's not really interested in penalizing you for being bad at platforming. And I like that. Why punish the player for something that your game has nothing to do with? Seriously though, where the fuck is Lou? Yeah, she's just not here. Objective, acquire the brain box. It is really fucking good. You can pick it up real cheap. And feel free to try and beat my times, because the times I set on my first time through, pretty damn good. And it's super fun. Like, this is... I know I'm like the gamer, the hardcore gamer, whatever, but it's really fun to optimize your solutions for this. Like, it's like a whole new puzzle. Like, figuring it, and when it works, it feels so good because everything just goes right through. And when it doesn't work, you're like, ah, shit, like, how can I fix it? It's really good. It's like a whole new layer to the game that I'm not really showing off, which is why I'm talking it up so much. Because really showing it off and trying to optimize it the best I could would be like 20, 30 minutes a level, at least. If I, like, really wanted to do it, you know? But I think that's probably the best way to go through this game. Jell, Snufkin's drunk right now. He's really surly at Turtle for, like, no reason. There's a very good reason to be surly at Turtle. He's Turtle. Hey, you better not take on the legend, Jell. I'm at the king and all that. Anyways, let's figure out what we're doing. Acquire the brain box. Let's get to some... I can see. I do like how the light is actually, like, this is just a physical thing in front of you. Satellite. The brain box is on the satellite. There's a restroom, second class, access tube, rather. Full room, first class. Data jack, brain box. That's not terribly helpful. New insertion. Okay. Okay, we could insert it here in space. I guess because it's just a simulation, we don't get to see this elevator go all the way down, huh? Oh yeah, check it. We're actually moving on the elevator. This is how the space elevator works. So fucking rad. Like, everything, even, like, he even wants to get across, like, the functional, chunky technology feel in, like, the levels. And I love that. And I love how this level feels, this feels very different from the inside of the stock exchange. And it should. Because the inside of the stock exchange is a stock exchange. And this is the outside of an emergency air. For more air, I assume when we get inserted, we have right, the Abbey Yo-Yo Space Elevator. That's a bit on the nose, folks. I mean, I guess it must work. Okay, let's get inside. Away from gantry. Oh, that just tells me I can jump up here. Just use a gun, Frank. Okay, you want me to use a gun? Here, we'll use a gun. Great. Oh, shit, we're flipping. Aim Boy. I wish it was called an Aim Boy. Oh, no. Here, hold on. Rotate again. There. What if I just do this? Nice. No recoil in space, I guess. Anyways, that would make this level really fucking difficult because, now we don't have any. This entire area has no air, but it is a way to get in, I think. It doesn't set off alarms because I think they assume nobody would be stupid enough to do that. Also, you get to pike your bike? You park your bike? Which implies people bike onto the elevator, which is cool. No, he was not in Aerial TF2 League. I did run into a few unexpected people in the TF2 League sometimes, but no one from these communities. Here's the restroom. Oh, that's creepy. Friendliness. We use up all their water and force them to land. A pressure hatch. A one-way pressure hatch. I broke through on both sides, that's rad. Anyway. Rampinadas. Oh, it's a ramen empanada. Huh. Is that a thing? Yeah, Happy JoJo did competitive at some point, but I never ran into him. He flirted with it and didn't like it. Because he thought that Highlander wasn't that interesting. Highlander wasn't the optimal way to play the game to him, but Sixes didn't have space to play Spy, so he just thought TF2 was dumb to play competitively. There is a satellite. The satellite. There's the satellite. And that's our target, is the satellite. But we're on the space elevator. And it seems like the satellite is synced to the space elevator. So we're not going to get any closer to it. Anyways, there's a door here that blocks us. This literally cannot be opened. just as a hint to the player. Oh, that's lights. What? Oh, I think I managed to shove my head through the ceiling, through these gates, and activate the alarm. Hold on, let's turn that off.
Alarm deactivated.
Okay, that's not funny the second time.
Alarm deactivated.
I think it's just done now. Oh, I see. The lasers are up there. Wait, and then what does this do? Oh, so each laser in order. Oof. But how do I open the door? Much harder to navigate in this red alarm light. In fact, let me restart, because that's impossible to see. Much better. Okay. Oh, I see. Stay really low so you don't set off the laser. And apparently ruin everything. But how do I open the door? Oh. I can cut through this. Now let's stay really high so we don't trigger it. Oh, I don't open that door. I need someone down there turning them off in order. And then... Wait, is this a multi-person thing or a single-person thing? Delicate control panel overhead, look up. That gear has. Okay, so I do that and then let someone get on it. And then I put it back up and they jump from there to the satellite. And meanwhile, I can exit this way. Oh, and this is the other side of the bathroom. Okay. So meanwhile, I've probably got Lou out there, just sitting there, breathing recycled air, hoping we finish our shit. And she grabs more air. And then Lou is here. And there's no fucking way to jump from here to there. So now I'm a little confused. Hold on. Does it pass by close enough? You know, okay, I think it passes by just close enough that you can jump. I need better legs. You can't fucking make that jump. You can't make that jump. NAOC installation. Okay, so Poncho has to be the one to get here, because only Poncho can hack. So Poncho's the one who stays outside the whole time? Must be. And Maisie's the one who goes in the vent to turn off the lasers. I guess. And then Lou is the one who goes through. I guess it doesn't matter which one of them. That's it. I remember when we were hacking things? We'll do that. I typed X because I'm an idiot. See, I'm assuming, yeah, triggers. So then I do that, and these open up. And then I can drop down here. And... I should have been playing tunes. Sorry, folks. Oh, there's more air for me, just in case. Then what? How come I can't take a picture of this? That's weird, isn't it? Weird? Should be taking a picture of this. What do I do here? Because I don't want to get all the way here and not know. Oh, shit! No, wait, don't do that. God, and then I have to... Okay. So, no, not connect. Lever. Data jack, is it? Data jack 0. And then we got the brain box. Oh no. Guys, I'm really sorry. I don't think there's a way to get Nell back. I think it's impossible. Oh, there's a way to shove Nell into the ceiling. It's what she would have wanted. It's what how she would have wanted to go, I think. It's fair to say. Everybody? Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Uh-oh. Not yet. That works. I don't. Oh my god. I'm gonna have to be really fucking careful with my air, but... technically. And then what? Wait, how the fuck do I get down? How the fuck do I get down? Do I jump up here? Okay, I'm here. I walk here. I jump. What's a weevil magnet? Oh shit, I have a weevil magnet. That's probably a lot easier than exploiting the game to tell Nell to stand 50 times so she clips all the way through the top, huh? How well does it work though? When did they just gave me that at some point. I wonder how long I've had it. Oh, it just like teleports it. Right? That's cute. Wait, I think I just teleported Nell to nowhere? Because I activated- okay, I just activated that and then put it in my pocket. And so Nell instantly teleported to nowhere. Thankfully, this is just the planning phase, it's not real. So if I were going for optimal time, I would have to be a monster and leave Nell, but we don't have to do that. Okay! So now I have a plan. Wait. Do I have a plan? Because my plan involved having... uh-oh. Because my plan involved having multiple people. Hold on, I need to check one thing. Yeah, I'm gonna use Blink. I'm gonna set up Blink. But I just realized I can't, I won't, it's not a three-person mission, so I can't just have someone sit here. And like, operate this for me. So I'm gonna have to have someone else sit here and operate this for me. Stop, like, running away like that. Okay, hold on. That point. God, zero gravity is so obnoxious. Yes. Really? Really? Thank you. Shit, it's not a data jack. How do I do this? Because I need to be on there and I need to flip this switch. That's not how that's supposed to work. But... oh, right. Yeah. Hold on. I knew I was reading something. So I'll have one shot at that because... oh no, if I put it inside, it won't break the glass, so it should stay in the same position. It won't be in zero gravity. I feel like this is not the correct way to do this because I'll have to put the gun down here and have it make a really bizarre aim to here, and I feel like there's probably another option I'm supposed to use. But I think this is what I did last time, and I can't use Nell. Nell can't pull switches. I was thinking I could use Nell and then magnet Nell back to me, but that's not gonna work. It's gotta be the gun, I guess. That's a really awkward shot, because I'm gonna have to lay it on the floor and find a pitch for it, but... Oh. That shell casing is gonna kill somebody on that planet. It doesn't have an atmosphere. I've decided. Okay. Let's blink one. Let me set up my other blinks real quick. I don't have to break glass to get in. In fact, I can't. Like, that's not a practical... I can't get... Actually, that would be the fast way to do it, Chai, wouldn't it? I'm gonna do this the way I'm supposed to, but that would potentially be the fast way. Wait, hold on. Let's just see. Town map. Gate 2? Dot open. Okay, that's right. Now you let me snap a picture of it. Whatever. Oh shoot, I left Nell over there. Oh, I can just do this. So I have to place it and then use it? That's a little weird, but okay. Plink 182. I could. What's your favorite Blink 182 song, Shell? Yeah, I don't fly around, but you're right that I could go. I actually could go above the control box and aim my gun down into it, and that would be the fast way to do it, and just break the glass. But the thing is about that, I would have to shoot it, break the glass, spin the wheel, then reposition the gun in 0G so that the laser is looking right at the pitch control, and then hope that it stays still, and then go up, and then use, and then fire the gun to hit the pitch control. And that sounds very fiddly, and I don't have infinite air. It's probably pretty doable, and it's probably the fastest way, but I'm gonna do it like normal, because I feel obligated to play the game normally. Anyways. Okay. So they wrote, oh, first let me do this. Data jack. Data jack. Data jack? Zero. It's the thing I need. Okay. Exit. Blink. Blink. Free. Exit. Weaver. Data jack. Great. Right? Oops. Not Data Jack 3, Data Jack 1, or 0. I'm stupid. There we go. And blink 182. All the small things. Don't know the lyrics. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 20, 21, 22. I'm not doing it, folks. Too much. Okay. So that was all planned very accurately. Let's go fuck it up. Let's fuck it up so hard. You know, the more I think about it, Chai, the more I think you're right that that's the fast way to do it. Because you can skip this whole section entirely. Maybe I'll try both. Easy. You don't need to use the mega jump for that. Wait. Oh, shoot. Here's the part I didn't think through. Okay, I can do this. It's fine. Excellent. Hold on, let's just put the, I don't feel like walking over there and grabbing it. Okay. One, two. Oh, wait, I need to have a jump. No, zero, one. And then zero, one over there. I remember that. Well, this kind of screws up my order, but that's fine. Oh, wait. Okay, so this should make my Weaver deactivate each one of these lasers in order. Theoretically. Oh wait, hold on, since I'm going up, let's give me 2 seconds. On the first one. Amp wait one, data jack zero, wait one, data jack one. That's good. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fucker! What?
Alarm deactivated.
Exit, blink. Let's only give myself 1 second on that first one then. Because I was already waiting. Ooh, okay. The long way. I am gonna do this the short way too. I'm gonna try the short way at least once after I do the long, normal way. Because, this is brutally long. It's offending my sensibilities. What is that, like a 70? Okay, why is that? What did I just spell wrong? Oh, -5? Nope. Why are you not working? Am I misspelling when I'm not looking? But like a 2-year-old? Well, I misspelled when I looked that time. That's not quite right. There we go. Get it facing the right direction. Trying to remember how I set my blinks. Yeah, blink one is just fire. And blink two is the gate, and blink three is the other thing. Got it. Blink three is nail. Where do I go from here? Oh, right there. And I pre-opened this to save time that I then proceeded to waste everywhere else. It's fine. I didn't lower it. I fucked up. It's a good thing there's nobody fucking here. I need to lower the marquee so I can stand on it. I'm the worst. Okay. I could have maybe lowered it with fire. Some of you might be thinking, you could just shoot the gun and lower it. But I'm not super convinced that the gun won't move or jitter around when I fire it. And I'm not super convinced that the bullet won't break the glass even. I'm being paranoid about it. I probably could have just blinked once and made it shoot the button and then blinked once and made it shoot the button again, but I didn't 100% trust that. I don't really count on that working past one shot. I'm not even sure the first shot's gonna work. It's an iffy angle. It's fine though. And all I have to do is make this one jump. I'm not even remotely close. What have I done? How do I make this work? I've missed something. There's no fucking way I could have made that jump, surely. Maybe? I guess if I fall, I just, like, come back, so I'll give it a shot. There's no fucking way in hell that works. This is tricky. Oh! Concept. Really dumb concept. I don't know if this will work. Can any of you guys figure out what I'm gonna do? It has to do with a marquee. I think this will work. Fuck me. The elevator's always going up, actually. Very slowly, technically. But so is the satellite. Oh. I guess I don't need to do this, but as long as I'm here. Please? That was good. You should be able to figure out what I'm doing by now, if you're real clever. I hope this works because it's cool as shit. I'm really excited about it. And it's all the more exciting because I had to do it all myself, game developers. It would suck if I just hit a button and it happened for me in a pre-rendered shit. Here we go. Nope. Nope, it didn't work. Oh, wait. Better idea. Much better idea. That, but simpler. I think, well, let me just see how the physics work on this thing. It only kind of worked the way I wanted it to. Here, hold on, let's... Whoops, not quite. I want to stand on the top here to practice something. Well, practice isn't the right word. But I want to see what happens. But I need to, It's actually kind of hard. Okay. Might work. If I act, I'll think of any other solutions while I'm setting this up, I guess. Because I don't have them. I have Amazon Prime. But only because there's like shows on it I watch, and then I cancel it. Does that- wait, do I have Twitch Prime? If I have Amazon Prime, do I have Twitch Prime? Is that a thing? Is there something with the spinning I can do? Not really. Is there a way to lower the okay. If this doesn't work, I'm gonna look for a way to lower the satellite somehow, but I don't know of any way to do that. I can't think of how that would work. Right? There's not. Oops, I just accidentally hit fire. Oh, that's cute. Gantry release emerge. I'll try those next. First, I'm gonna try the idea I have. But shit, that might be my solution right there. Or at least part of it. I bet that's it right there. But I also bet it sets off alarms. No. Okay. Try that again. Damn, that's hard. It's very hard to balance that. Sorry, here? Fuck it, I'm gonna go ahead and see what happens. Oh. Hey, problem! I need to be on that. So that's half of my answer. But how do I break those? Or can I just jump up there? Hold on. Maybe it's really dumb and I can just jump up there somehow. No way in hell can I jump that. Okay. Yeah, but I need the gun to be here to activate these switches. No, I don't. No, I don't anymore. There's a door. There it is. Okay. Okay, that's not cool. Oops, I didn't mean to. I meant to just pick it up, not to put it away. LOL. I'm close. Okay, please read what Shell just wrote. The superstructure of my diapers is a product of my material conditions. You're welcome. I probably said that pretty loud. I bet my neighbors hear me sometimes. I have noticed one of them looking a little weirded out recently. Oh, if I was optimizing, I would have cut this first, huh? Probably. Yeah, finally! You've caught me saying something embarrassing. The truth come out. Here we go! And now this is in position? And I just go beep beep. Whoa! Hello, man.
Objective complete.
And just to please you guys. Even though it cost me time. Oh, and I can just walk back too. That's much easier. There we go. So easy. Nailed it. Not a terrible time. I think of a lot of ways to optimize it. I think when I did this level in 1:59, I did just go across the top and shoot my way into the control booth. And then, like, repositioned the gun quickly to shoot the gantry up. I'm not sure if that's true or not, but I bet it's worth the time save versus dealing with the lasers. Maybe not, though. Anyways, we planned it, so now we just need to do it. Ramen pot pie. Chili ramen fries. Oh, Radical Gin's ramen classic. Nice. Hey, it's the cat who sells illegal items. I guess he's a normal cat as his day job. We did the big job. That's probably enough for us to thrive on. Lock situation. That's fine. We've got the keys. It's our room. Time has passed, though. Looks like we finally indulged in our photography hobby. Our books seem to have veered further towards the novels. I think last time they were all technical manuals. Gilberto. Made more launchers. Original rejection letters. Financial guide to family caregivers. Hospice care. Sort of tucked away in the back here. Hmm. It's a really sweet ending. And it works really well. It's like, you were all focused on the puzzles and all that shit, but best times were your friends, weren't they? And there you have it. That's Quadrilateral Cowboy. A really genuinely sweet game about performing heists with 80s technology in the future. And I love it a lot. It's got a workshop. There's a couple good mods. But I'm not going to do them. There's one that's really hard. There's a couple that fit in with the game. And that's it. I wish there were more. But the game itself doesn't need more. It introduces a lot of new things. And there's a point where you feel like maybe I could have done more with the multi-squad thing. But you know what? It ends well. I like it a lot. And, next time we're gonna do No More Heroes 2. A game that's not sweet at all. Despite its difficulty level. Being called sweet. It's the opposite of whatever that is. Yeah, I think it's a little too late anyway. It's almost midnight, so I'm not gonna do it. I thought I was gonna finish at like 11. And then I was wrong. It looked like I was aiming for like an 11:10 finish, so I was going to go into No More Heroes 2, but it's already midnight. So yeah, I'm just going to cut it here. And thanks for watching, everybody.